because the heaven is open. Yeah. Because there are some apostles in the land. Yeah. Oh, you didn't hear me. I said because there are some apostle generals in the land that have the key to open the heaven. And yet all heaven is open over the nation. So God said, tell my people, I am taking them to a height that they have never gone before.
I receive it.
They are going to a higher level because the apostles and the prophets of the land have been praying. And they have opened heaven. So impossibility start becoming possible.
Hallelujah.
I want you to hear this. I believe strongly that what is going to happen here tonight is going to set us up. Tomorrow is going to be an amazing, amazing night. Because tomorrow morning, I heard that from Soga Kope, we have about 80 pastors that are chartering three full buses, and they are coming for our leadership training tomorrow morning. Yeah, this was amazing. Listen, we went on Wednesday to Soga Kope to preach to hundreds of pastors, and God gave me a word with the subject, stay connected. And I delivered this message. Little do I know that the light and the grace of God that rests upon this message stir up the heart of the people. And they said, we heard you are having a conference. Where is it? Because we want to come. Like joke, I asked them to go and register how many people that want to come, that we will get them a bus to come. 80 people registered. Tomorrow from even Togo, we have some pastors coming. I know that all these people that are going to be arriving from different places and more people are coming. I was told rather that some people came here in the morning.
Oh my God.
Expecting that the service should start in the morning. That's how hungry.
Yes.
Oh, they're still here. That's how hungry people are for the things that God is about to do in this place. So I don't want you to miss any of the services because it's going to be awesome. Somebody say it's going to be awesome. With big honor and privilege, I would like us to honor my dear friend that I flew in to be with us also in this conference. I was with him last January in his church. He's a father in the land of Nigeria. He lives in Abuja. They have a mega ministry there. God is using him to do mighty work. And he has come and flew in all the way from Abuja to be with us. Please, with a big, big, big clap of faith, let us make Bishop Tom Press. Welcome to Ghana. Hallelujah. 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 Tomorrow, Bishop Tom Press is going to have us a leadership meeting that we are having in the morning, because he's a man that has been on the way for many, many, many years. He has started a mega ministry, not only in Abuja, but across the globe. He has a lot of ministry under him, and I want him to come and share some tools with us tomorrow. That thing that has sustained him.
Yes, sir.
He went to Abuja when Abuja was not Abuja.
Yeah.
And he fought the battle, and he's still here now. All the ones that are coming, they are coming to pay homage to him, because he was there to fight the battle. So he's going to show us how you can break a new ground, how you can go to places. Joshua said in Joshua chapter 5, Joshua said, are you for us? ability to fight every demon. Joshua was such a fighting spirit that he was ready to even fight an angel, a warring angel. So there are some people that are anointed to fight. So Bishop will be showing us some of those tools. And then we have Reverend Carter McKenzie all the way also from our church in USA. He will be sharing with us. Hallelujah. Please make him welcome. Hallelujah. 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 He will be sharing with us also tomorrow, and he will be giving us some tea concerning how you can start a ministry in a strange land. Somebody say ministry. In a strange land. So he's going to tell you how New International Church came into Chicago, how we were connected, and what really happened to him that made him to be connected to such a ministry and to be humble to the call with American accent, submitting under an African accent. There is something that he has seen. He will be sharing with us tomorrow in ministry. Spirit of humility. How he take you to the next level.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, as we introduce the man of God, I also want to recognize I have my two daughters here, my two beautiful daughters. They were here last 7 years ago, 2007, and now they are back with me on a mission. And so please, grace and joy can all rise on your feet. Let them see you. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes. It's such a wonderful thing to take your children to mission so that they see what God is doing. And in that way, God can also empower them to use them to do greater works.
Yes,
somebody say amen.
Amen.
Our teams are here. Minister Dominic, I have four of our elders with me on this trip. So Minister Dominic, Rosemary, Renata, and then Reverend Mackenzie, can you all stand up one more time? Let them recognize you. Those are the elders of the International Church. Hallelujah. In our headquarters, hallelujah, God bless you. In our headquarters, we have about 14 elders that are, when I talk about 14 elders, I'm talking about Swiss people, that God has raised up under our ministry, ordained them, and consecrated them to do the work of God. And so we have few of them with us today, and we thank God for their lives. And then we thank God for all our members that have come with us. We will have time to introduce them tomorrow proper, and they're going to be able to say something if they so desire. Amen. But tonight, I have my own mentor, my spiritual father, the one that gives me coverage wherever I go, a man that has serious spirit of success. Somebody say success. In him. And whoever that connects to him, you have no other choice but to succeed. You didn't understand what I'm saying. I said the man we have in the house tonight is a man that if you are connected to him, even if you don't want to succeed, it is too late. Oh, you didn't hear me. And so that's the man that God has privileged to give to us. I am not ashamed to say that I have been under his ministry for over almost 20 years now.
Wow.
Almost 20 years. I have been under his ministry. He's still pastoring me. It's very important that you hear that. He's still what? Pastoring me. So if he said we are having this program now, and he come and he said we are changing, there is no questioning. All you need to hear from me is yes, sir. And each time I have ever done that, God has always opened a better door for me. Because every pastor needs a pastor. Please, with a clap offering and standing innovation, make welcome my pastor.
Thank you. you expect, you will receive it. I don't know who is oppressing me here, whether these people or these Swiss people. I said, what you expect is what God will deliver. Clap your hands and shout. Up your voice, Yahweh. Are there worshippers in this house? Are there lovers in this house? Come on, shout it. We bow. You are doing well. Sing it again. We bow down. Hallelujah. Come on. We bow. We worship you, Father, and we bless you for open atmosphere, for open heavens. We thank you for healings that are about to manifest in this meeting. Thank you for rising ministries here. Thank you, my God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, let the saints of God shout a big amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Let's be seated. Hallelujah. Thank you, choir. Thank you, choir.